G'day, I'm Shuey from Smoked Barbecue Sauce, and today I'm going to be smoking pulled beef. So let's get into it. Today I've chosen to use oyster blade. Well, that's what we call it in Australia. You might know it as flat iron steak or butler's steak. Now, it doesn't matter what you call it, I like using this cut for pulled beef purely because it has a really nice texture similar to brisket. It also has a large fat vein running through it similar to beef cheeks. And when cooked low and slow and all that collagen breaks down, you are just left with a liquefied sticky jelly that is just packed full of flavor. But the outside fat is no good to us. It is hard and it's also covering up that silver skin, which we want to remove as well. We need it all gone as we want our seasoning on the meat, not on the fat. Today, I'm going to be making a coffee rub. Now, don't stress, you are not going to taste any coffee flavoring through it. It will, however, boost any sweet or savory flavors we use in the rub. And also, due to the high acidity of coffee, it's going to help tenderize our beef. So into a bowl, we need to mix 1/4 cup of ground coffee, 2 tablespoons of dark brown sugar, 2 tablespoons of cayenne pepper, 2 tablespoons of garlic powder, 2 tablespoons of onion powder, 2 tablespoons of paprika, 1 tablespoon of ground cumin, 1 tablespoon of kosher salt. Mix this up real good to make sure every time you grab some seasoning, you are getting a bit of everything to ensure an even coating, or transfer the seasoning to a shaker. Just remember to give a good shake before each use. Now apply a good coating of the rub to the beef from around about 12 inches in height. This just allows the different size particles time to separate and fall evenly over the meat. I'll be using a Weber Smoky Mountain to smoke at 250 degrees Fahrenheit using the Minion method today. Now, how I set up my WSM is by half filling a chimney starter with lump charcoal and lighting it up. Once that's all ashed over, I'll dump that into a well we created in the unlit charcoal. I'll also pop on a few chunks of smoking wood. I'll be using cherry and pecan for today's smoke. I'm not using the water bowl for this cook. I have a deflector plate in. This is purely so I do not have to worry about topping up the water in a long cook. I will use a drip tray though. Now put the lid on, open all the vents and allow the WSM to heat up before we start closing down the vents and stabilizing the heat. Now that the smoker is stable and running at that 250 degrees Fahrenheit mark, we are ready to put our beef in. So just place it in the center of the cooking grill and insert an internal temp thermometer and set it to 160 degrees Fahrenheit. Put the lid back on and grab a drink. This is going to take around 4 hours. The internal temp has finally reached 160 degrees Fahrenheit. So we can now wrap that beef in some foil with some warmed up beef stock. This is going to do a couple of things. By wrapping it in foil, it's actually going to push that beef past the stall, that area where the internal temp doesn't keep rising, and it just sort of stalls at that temp for an hour or two. And also, by adding the beef stock, we're boosting more flavor into it. So we just need to lay down a double layer of foil and place the beef in the center. Now, add about 1/2 cup of warm beef stock, then wrap it up nice and tight. Now, place that back into the smoker and set an alarm for 200 degrees Fahrenheit. After another 2 hours, our beef has hit that 200 degrees Fahrenheit mark. So we need to check it and just see how it's probing with a metal skewer. Temp is only a guide. The true testament to whether or not that beef is done is how it feels. Anywhere between 200 and 210 degrees Fahrenheit, the beef should be ready. So we'll always set the thermometer at the lower mark, and from there on, we're just going to check it by feel. Look at that. Every part of it is probing soft with absolutely no resistance on the skewer. So we need to wrap and hold this beef for a couple of hours before we dig in and start eating it. I'll open it up and allow it to steam away some of that heat for about 10 minutes before wrapping it up in the foil again. Now wrap it up in an old towel and place another at the bottom of the cooler. Then place the wrapped up beef on top of the towel, place another towel on top and close the cooler. Now relax and have a couple of drinks as the hard work is all done. So the 2 hours is finally up. It's time to make some pulled beef. But firstly, we need to get that beef out of its cocoon of towels. So just place the beef and all of that liquid into a tray and start shredding the beef. If you come across any larger bits of fat that didn't render down, just put them aside. How good does that look? Slow cooked, smoked, pulled beef with a coffee rub. I think it's time for a taste test. I want to grab a piece with some bark on it and get some of that liquid gold as well. Wow, super beefy flavor and absolutely no coffee taste. Seriously, it just doesn't get any better than this. Well, there you have it. Smoked pulled beef with a coffee rub. If you'd like to check out this recipe a little further, there's a link in the description to the full recipe and a list of ingredients and step-by-step instructions. Thanks for watching. It's now time for me to dig in and have a good feed. Cheers. Helps if it does. It helps if I'm recording. Birds, go away. Time to get the bee farm. Time to get the bee farm. It sounds like my neighbor's mowing bricks. Time to wrap. Waka waka waka. Don't know why I did that. Long day. The internal temp has finally reached an internal and set the thermometer for 200 anywhere between 200 and 200. What is that? It sounds like a chainsaw. Slow cooked, smoked with a coffee rub. I thought that was a plane for a minute, it's just a car. Oh no, there's a plane. Are you kidding me? You've done your lawns. Well, there you have it. Well, there you have it. Smoked pulled pork. Well, there you have it. Smoked pulled beef with a copy. I'm gonna go over there and wrap that around their head.